Yo, what's good? What's good? What's good? It's the Hard Food Podcast.
Back again.
Back again. My name is Juice English.
ASMR.
My name is Juice English.
Black Sea.
Still Black Sea?
Still Black Sea.
Still Black Sea.
AKA. Yeah.
I'm Black Sea, man.
It's not AKA.
AKA, the culture. AKA, he's iron, he's him.
AKA, something like people deserve to remind you.
It's, what's your name?
Black Sea. Black Sea.
Yeah, man, Black Sea in the house.
And this is episode 120. Episode 120.
Is it 120?
Yeah.
Sure?
Are
you sure?
No,
is it
120,
you know?
120?
Mad. I can count. Yo, Karani, yeah. You've been slowing down the thing, you know?
No, it's been mad still. But yeah, man, what's good? Make sure you subscribe.
Yeah, like, subscribe, share, all them thing. Follow, make a TikTok account for us. Make videos and post us. Like, we don't really do it, just like you do it. And then, like, tag us in, and then we might repost it, but we can't guarantee that because we don't want to be affiliated with no stupidness.
Yeah,
but yeah,
I ain't got time for TikTok.
No.
Way too real or to make reels.
Chase.
Back in the roof, you know.
Back in the roof.
Yeah. What was it? Can you repeat that for the people at the back?
Eh?
Can you repeat that?
I said I ain't got time to TikTok. Double entendre. Don't even ask me how.
No.
I'm way too real to make reels.
Jesus.
Dynamite.
Jesus. You know the sound of
that? You lot don't have bridges like us yet. The hype up the man. Yeah. You need to check your friends, you get me?
Timbo slice in the building.
Yeah.
In my tongue, Rasta slice.
Jump! Rasta. Jump!
Farthest buck in the building.
Yay.
Rasta slice.
That's
how
that is. That's how that is.
Farthest buck.
Blessings upon blessings to everybody and love and justice. And some water memory.
What's the water memory?
I saw
it sounds like an infection.
It's got nothing to do with wet WAP.
Okay.
It's just some scientific thing I've been looking at.
What is it though? Explain quickly, if you can do it.
Basically, it's finally... that's too complicated. But you can move water molecules around the world just by putting electric.
Oh, do you mean being a water bender, Avatar: The Last Airbender?
No. But they've done some research and stopped autism with some young boys in France.
Yeah,
so. And it's a Nobel Prize winner, the one who found HIV, discovered what the HIV. Yeah. So yeah, anyway.
I hear that. I get that.
That's
so
excellent.
We might be going to the new technology for
Water.
Yeah, water.
Because holy water in the world, isn't it?
Yep.
About 70%.
Can you imagine that though? We're made of how much water?
Is it 70?
But if we have too much, we can drown. Is that mad?
But also, I don't know. Actually, no. It's not really that mad. Because if we made it 70% water, if we make it to 80%, then we die, innit? Just stay within the limits.
But they said that we've only discovered, I forgot how much it was. It's a small percentage.
No, but that's like saying,
Tim,
we get it, man, we get it.
No, but it's like saying, we're 30%, we're 30% meat.
We get it.
If we had some more meat, we would die. It. Of course you would.
No, but if you keep eating meat, you're not going to die. But if you have too much water, you can drown.
But the thing is, if you have less meat, if I have more meat, you're not going to die.
How not?
Because the thing is, you'll just be dehydrated.
And then die?
No, you're not.
See, you can't die from dehydration?
Obviously, no.
You can die from dehydration.
However, that's if it gets to if your water content gets really low. That's for an average person. At the end of the day, you've got to think about it. If a person who is, for example, say, the week I do a show.
Yeah.
I'll drink 11 litres of water a day.
Man.
Blood, fire.
Yeah.
I heard it's 12 to drown.
Limits, isn't it?
Redlining, you know. My redlining.
But basically now, all that's to do is to wash out the water that's in me. To replace it, for the whole week, and then I stop drinking water, and then the rest of the water comes out. Now, you get dehydrated, but
so you get dry mouth, like cotton mouth.
I'm not gonna die. Your mouth dries out like
you get cotton mouth and the thing on the side. You can't.
No, you don't do that. There's cream and
Just wipe it off.
Carmex on or something.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. I've got things to research when I get on. Waterbending. Carmex. Where was I? Okay, how's everyone's week been? How's everyone doing?
Stress, man. Mad stress, yeah.
You stressed as well?
Yeah, I'm mad stressed this week. Mad.
Same, to be fair.
I'm mad stressed.
Like bare, I got bare quarters.
Bare things to do.
My cortisol's building up. I just look bloated, man. Bloated all week.
I've been like, just stressed, man.
Oh, wait, you got cortisol?
Obviously, cortisol does build up here.
I don't know what cortisol is, to be honest.
Cortisol is a stress hormone.
This is a science podcast, you know. This is a science podcast. We had to talk about music once.
Cortisol, when it builds up in your brain, you can say, for example, it makes you retain water.
Okay.
So, if people are getting ready for a shot and they're stressing, I'll tell them, yo, relax, because the fact is you're going to retain more water. So you need to keep your cortisol to low.
You can't tell someone to relax, though.
Yes, you can.
Or you can
try and take some ashwagandha to lower your cortisol levels.
Wait.
Yeah, what's this?
I'm just wondering, we are recording it, because I can't see the numbers going up on that one.
Yeah, we are recording. Hold on. You're saying that. I don't think we're recording juice.
Is it me?
You're number one.
Jeez. Oh, mad.
Number one.
Pause.
Oh, alright, yeah, ashwagandha, man, I searched that still. Alright, cool.
No, should
you
just said ashwagandha?
No, I said ashwagandha still.
You said that and some youth's going, huh?
Alright, cool.
Yes, sir.
What's so stressful about your week? Do you care to delve? Do you care
stuff,
to share?
Man.
Do you care to expose yourself?
Obviously, one of my kids had to go to hospital.
Oh, okay.
So, that was that. Bare work, man. That's work. It's like, yo, you know, you're just at work and it's just bare work.
Mm.
And everyone's like, yo, bare work. And you think to yourself, yo, is it just me that have to do this for bare work? And then you go to work and everyone's like, bare work to do, you know?
I can't even.
You know what's mad? Like, sometimes you feel like you're on your own. You're sitting there and you're thinking, I'm feeling like you. It feels like this. I'm going downstairs. Then people stress. Like, you know, you feel good. And you think, yo, it's peak. Because everyone's under pressure.
Is it more work than usual or something? Or?
More work. Bare work, man. Bare work. But it's just like goals, man. Bare work to do. But, I think, you know what, like, the whole corona thing, the whole, like, lockdown business, all that business, it's just magical, because I think, because we're coming to the end of the first term, like, because you never really have a full, proper break in the holiday, because you did, but, like, you don't feel, like, normal. The man can't go on holiday.
Yeah.
Man can't do that. And because of that, it's like everything's just building up, so the pressure's come through.
Yeah, definitely.
It's a long term. But yeah, man, it's bare stress, man. Bare stress. It's like last week, yeah. Two weeks ago.
Mm.
I went out with the man doing now.
Yeah.
DJ Gavin Amari's up there, Gavin Spar. And then, man, we're like, ah. Let's go to this bar, because it was supposed to be a club, so they opened as a bar, so it got open earlier.
Did you say this? That's when we recorded?
Just her? No, I didn't.
Oh.
That was the day after.
Oh, okay.
So then,
yeah. Oh, you told us in the gym. Here, go on.
So then, yeah, I went out now, but they said, no, we'll go shisha lounge. So you go to the shisha lounge thing now. So me now, I ain't no shisha geezer, you know. Mm. I'm not one of them, man.
You could be cool, man.
Anyway. I'm not going to come
in. Just looks cool.
I don't care if it's cool.
You've ever been to Andrews?
Yeah.
No, he's one of them.
I've never been to
him. No, it's not really me, to be fair.
So then, you could be coming.
Who doesn't get you high?
So then, basically, I went there now, and you get to the thing, and it's like, you got to download the app.
Yeah, yo.
The Corona app. After you check in. I didn't check in. I couldn't find it. And then he's supposed to keep everything. As soon as I downloaded the app, I showed the man, yeah, I'm going to check in. deleted the app. Then I deleted the data that's on my phone. So I deleted data. And you're just like, yo, this is long, you know.
Yeah,
it's and just makes me not want to go out.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to stay in my yard. So I'm going to deal with this foolishness.
Well, yeah. I mean, birthday is next week, so I was going to do something on Halloween. But all these rules now. Basically now, households can't mix, can they?
Yeah.
So we got I had two tables booked. Well, obviously we got like six mandem on a table.
Yeah.
Already, like the whole six thing, like
that's annoying,
that's what I'm saying. No, the six mandem, like I got at least like seven friends. Like I can't just cut now. Like it's hard to kind of to bring it down. To be fair. Nah, I'm straight up like. If it was a table for like 10, everyone would have been.
So this is me now. You're taking juice out of our top friends on Instagram. You know, you have close friends. You're not going to see green anymore, you know.
You ain't seen those green things anymore, you know, on Insta.
Just bare pink.
Bare standards. You know? Bare standards, blood.
I mean, if you want to book a table, you can. Yeah, nah, this corona thing didn't get to me this week, bro. It's just annoying.
It's just mash up everything, man. Like,
everything. Like, every single thing.
Everything just mash. Everything mash, you know.
And the joke is, I'm loving how, like, that you see this whole tier thing now.
Mm.
And obviously now, Liverpool, everyone's crying in Liverpool because they're in tier three.
Yeah, carry on.
But then Boris tried to put Manchester in tier three.
No, but
it's
the
like, nah. He was like, nah.
He said, nah. Nah, it's not.
You know the Bugs Bunny meme?
Yeah.
But the thing is now, it's like, Alta, obviously, my big gym there, friend. Them man ain't locking up their gym, but not, because there's certain...
Where is that? Manchester?
In Liverpool.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, the thing is...
The guy that's getting a lot of attention?
Yeah.
Oh, you know him?
So basically, now that one's Nick Capone, isn't it?
That's it, Nick.
So basically, yeah, like, I look at it, I think to myself, yo, I know, yeah, that without gym, some of these men would have gone mad, you know.
Mm.
Because not everyone goes to the pub.
Yeah.
You get me? Some men just go gym, train, chill, chat to the man them, and then they go yard.
It's like...
Like our convo the other day in the gym.
Which one?
About when you vexed at working.
Oh, yeah.
Yo.
Yeah, nah, just
skim over that.
You're ready. But anyway.
Skim over that.
So basically, like, the gym, obviously, is like a social place as well.
Yeah.
And because they're locking that off, and I think to myself, yo, so you're locking off everything, and
but the science don't even support.
The science don't support it, fam. They're just making up the rules. They're literally, these men are making up as they go along. And I said this before, didn't I? They're making up as they go along.
Yeah.
And I just think, well, really, like, what is the plan? What are they trying to base it? It's like, are they trying to base it on sunlight? Because they're saying, in that case, they're saying London, the most densely populated place in the country.
Mm.
Yeah. Like, the capital city. Yeah. There's people galore. They're saying that's alright. Now, huh?
That's gone up to a tier 2 now, isn't it?
It's all mad.
But,
No, there was something online I saw where the 7 armed police turned up at a gym.
Yeah.
What was that about?
To give them £1,000 fine. Tell them to shut.
7... armed policemen.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's already more than the rule of six, but...
I didn't even think of it.
Is this
where it's going?
Mm-hmm.
I seen something over there. Well, no, sorry, today. It was like Lancaster's been... Is it? No, Lancashire. Lancashire's been moved up to tier 3, but they've made a deal so they can keep the gyms open. It's like, what? You can make deals now.
Because it's the
transfer market, like, negotiating that. Where's the science? I don't get it.
I don't get it. I think it's just all mad, and they're just mashing up everything, mashing up everyone's heads, and they just want everyone to be shook. Yo, as I've said a billion times, just get your vitamin D, buy your zinc, you'll be alright.
I need to get more vitamin D.
Yeah, do that. You'll be nice. Yeah, you keep having that.
Yeah? I need some more vitamin D. I just remembered.
But yeah, man.
Doctor said they got a deficiency.
Yeah. And
what? No, just the way you just skimmed over it.
It's a big deal to me. Got a deficiency in vitamin D.
Yeah, yeah, but apparently it's common with black people because there's nothing else right now for us. Same. Yeah. Up until about 2 months ago.
Okay. But yeah, man, get your
vitamin D. Buy some more.
Get some more. Get in. Get it in, man. Get healthy, man. At the end of the day, the fact is, you can only look after yourself. Do the best you can.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, with all this madness that's going on, you just think, yo, like, what's it going to be like after this? Because this is all mashing up the kids' heads as well. It's all mad.
I'm quite proud, but more so my daughter, because she's of that age, but it hasn't got to her, like, mentally at all. You know what I mean? You can tell she's still just happy-go-lucky and that. Obviously, and not to, like, chat a business, but she's not a bit lazy. I'll be like that. So, yeah.
But yeah, man, aside from that, it's mad. I know.
I know exactly what you mean, though. Like,
yeah.
My daughter's 4, but I don't know. Like,
yeah, now because like, they had cross-country and PE in it, and, like, it didn't go well. But,
yeah. It's like, even like the cinema locking up, like the cinemas, and you're just like,
yeah.
Oh, mad. Like, you just think to yourself, how do you expect people to build back from this?
How do you expect me to watch Black Widow? Should have come out like
March.
Yeah, it should have.
I mean, it's all mad, isn't it? There's not more.
Phase 4 is genuinely old.
This is not what you can really say. It's all mad. And
it's also drove me crazy. All the different gonna be theories. Tough. They're coming out with what's going to happen in Spider-Man 3.
I know, that's why I stopped watching them, you know.
It's irritating me.
Stop watching.
Because they're saying that Tobey Maguire is going to come back. What?
That would be sick though.
I'm not saying it isn't because I like Tobey Maguire.
Yeah, same.
But
it's going to be tough.
When
it's going
to
be sticky.
Is Mahershala Ali going to be doing Blade? What? This is all messing everything up.
It's not sure everything. I told you.
Corona, go away.
Yo,
and
we've got Marvel films to watch.
Yeah. 2020, man, it's been.
And jobs are being lost. And
fam, when is WandaVision gonna drop?
Suicide rates are kind of up at the moment.
Don't get me started on Suicide Squad.
Okay, that was a good one. Yeah, man. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah, I went up Snowden.
Oh yeah, you went up Snowden. Did. You get me? I saw the pics.
Man on his Bear Grylls and that. Yeah, man. Yeah.
It was a challenge though, but I'm not.
Galloway said you packed like if you're going to Mars or something.
You were like
you're gonna get flares and like SOS.
Yeah, I had a list. SOS. I had a list in it because I did my research and it was like, these are the things. These are the essentials.
How many days did you go for?
Just like 6 hours, to be fair.
So why did you take so much?
No, I didn't. I had a big list, but in the end, I didn't.
I heard the juice has gone up like it's Kilimanjaro.
Okay. Now, I ain't gonna lie.
Are anybody carrying your bags or stuff?
This is why my bag was ultimately very light, because I realised I would have to carry everything. So I even put up the first aid kit.
Did you put a Sherpa budget?
Yeah.
Yeah?
A couple of donkeys.
Did you put any budget for like a Sherpa or donkeys in it?
Nah.
And a Sherpa's not a van, by the way.
Is that Sherpa?
Sherpa.
I thought it was Sherpa.
No, those are the fancy ones.
Wait, what's the Sherpa? The animal, isn't it?
Yo.
Isn't it the animal? No, I'm thinking of Sherpa. The dogs, Sherpa dogs. I don't know what Sherpa is.
That's what they're saying.
Now, what's
the permanent markers.
But anyway.
The Sherpas are the guides. Like the mountain guide, man.
Oh, okay.
You buy them sticks.
Nah. To be fair, I thought I envisioned it much different. It's all trails with like guides. Guided.
Yeah, I know what it is. I've done it, you know.
Yeah, no. When I thought, like, when man popped up and said, "Yo, should we do Snowden?" I thought it was gonna be like Tomb Raider or something. Like I was, I was ready.
Seriously. You got the moon shorts out.
Nah.
Larry.
Now, I was ready though. I was ready for whatever.
Just dust them off like, it's time. Man's flicking them out in the air.
No. He's got it in the chest.
Nah, I was ready.
Time to work, girls.
I was ready. But I realised that it was like
the compass.
That was on the list. I had everything on the list ready for all that kind of situation. But when I actually decided to Google it, and then realize there's paths you could take and kids do it and people. I was like, oh, bro, this is some easy thing, some simple thing.
Was it easy though?
Well, yeah, it was.
No,
it was a challenge. But the more I think about it, I do feel like it was the weather. The weather was like the made it horrible. It was cool. Constant raining.
Who said they made it horrible? What God. Are you speaking about?
The weather made it horrible.
The weather made it horrible.
Yeah, 6 hours of straight rain, and when you get to the top, it's mad wind, and you're just sulking for the whole thing. I feel like I want to go back in that early summer, in my shorts, wink wink, and my vest. And just
really, he's gone too right, you know.
Yeah. Now I want to go like just like more chilling it. Obviously, it was just basically battling the elements in it.
Okay.
So okay. People kept messaging me like, "Yo, I didn't think you'd do snow then." So what do you mean? It's a mountain for open to the public, innit? What do you mean? What man can't do mountains? Yeah, yeah. What are you trying to say?
I took it.
Yeah, like I was like,
"You mean?"
Yeah.
Maybe you would, and bare
messages like the claps and that kind of stuff. I'm like, oh, I'm just walking up a mountain. You get me? Like, is this that astonishing? Yeah. Like,
what the heck?
Yeah, I was like, oh, like, all right, cool. No, see you
next week,
shall we? What's K2? I don't know what K2 is.
Go check how far K2 is.
What is it? Where is it?
Did you check it?
Is it higher than Snowdon?
Is it higher?
Is it in England? So in the UK?
No, you need a corona test.
Is it in the UK?
No.
Oh, no, right. That's good. Check no, I'm not catching any flights right now, so.
You're catching cool. feelings instead.
Yeah. Yes.
Bare feelings, no flights.
But yeah, man. That's Foxbone.
The D4 ringtone.
But yeah, man, it's been all mad, it's been all crazy.
Sorry, before you say it, on your phones, yeah. You know, like back in the day, you had your first phone, you always check, like, change your ringtone.
Yeah.
Your phone's on silent now, isn't it?
Mm. No. Oh, okay, it was for here, for the podcast.
My phone's always on silent.
My phone's on, like, do not disturb.
No, mine's always on loud.
Because it's on, I've got my watch on, so that buzzes, but apart from that.
My watch is on silent.
My phone's always on vibrate.
It's mad?
I don't ring, my phone don't ring. I'd be surprised if it even, that mechanism works.
You work?
I mean... But, yeah, what was I saying? Mad things, all the world just gone to pot.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Gone to pot. Right, so, topics? Yeah, I just want to say, yeah, went to the gym the other day, yeah. Juice was blasting ludicrous, you know.
Yeah. That whole gym session I had Ludacris on, you know, like, Ludacris Essentials and Afro Music.
Blasting Ludacris, yeah, like you'd never heard it before.
Nah, it's not always about staying up today, you know.
You see these holes? You know, bro, do you know what it means? It's like the genius breakdown.
Jeez jumps out of the car. Roll out. Roll out.
Nah, I think when you pull the world, listen to yeah, I was listening to, this is irrelevant, Southern Hospitality.
Yeah.
I didn't realise that was JD's tune. And
where you been?
I didn't realise Ludacris was on the remix. I thought it was Luda's tune.
Oh,
so, yeah, I was fully like, because I got to the end of the playlist. I was like, yo, how are you going to put that on there? And then I realised it was on there. But, yeah, man.
But yeah, carry on. So, what I was going to say, one thing I was going to say, so. Chip.
Oh, that's what I was gonna say. Yeah. Chip rest of Stormzy. But I didn't even take off. Like, I didn't know where to elevate.
Just get.
How do we proceed? Where do we start? I was asking you
from the beginning, normally.
From the beginning.
But where? Okay, where did it start? It's a weird one.
That's a question.
Mm.
Well, okay. From what I've ascertained.
Yeah, so what?
Ascertained.
Oh, yeah.
What I've gleaned from the good old interweb is that, is that the whole situation is a miscommunication. It's a mix-up because what's his name? Apparently, Chip said something on Waze.
Yeah.
And that was aimed at someone else.
Was it? How do we know that?
But that's what I've heard. It was aimed at someone else, but Storms has taken that offensively and he's taken it for himself. And then he come back at Chip with a bar, some bars, well, he's indirect about, I don't know, and I listened to it yesterday. Mm. And I don't know. Yeah, it's and then obviously
the boy's a bad boy, Lewis, you know.
Yeah,
call this, call this
bad boy.
Yeah, and so he came out with I don't know, and I think he was saying that his verse on I don't know was weak. And this is what I ascertained from Flowers. He says, you what school's weak on that? I told you to come bar with me against on some whatever tune. You turn that down. The next thing I know, you're coming to my house to come find me.
I think it's weird because...
Maybe that's me making it too easy. Or not getting the whole story.
I know people might say...
Don't kill me, Storms,
defend. This, that, and the other. But I think it's like... It's all like, you know, it's not real. It's all just music.
Of course it is.
Because at the end of the day, by doing this, everyone's gonna look around again.
Yeah, you'd think that, but
that's... Because the thing is, yeah, it's like now listen. I still think bar for bar, Stormzy is not in Chip's league.
Well, this is the thing. I was watching I've been watching some of Wiley's little.
I missed that.
What Will's saying, he said, which was quite. It is very true, 100%. He says, Storms, you're not a king of anything. Stop it. You're not the best at anything. The only thing you're good at is projection on the mic, and that's it.
Mm.
That's what you're good at.
He has got better though lyrically.
But I'm talking about.
That's still like.
Yeah. No, yeah, it's not levels. It's not levels.
It's like, I look at. It's like Storms is a good performer, as he said, good projection of his, like, good projection, like, voice, whatever, whatever. But I just think that, in terms of bar for bar lyrically.
But then, Stormzy. What's it called? Projection. I would have said delivery. Storms is projection.
But he's that's what Wiley actually said. Like,
and projection. His, like, lyric level is perfect for, like, drill. I think he sounds sick on this.
I don't know.
He
sounded sick on, I don't know.
Yeah, even when he responded to Wiley on the drill, it was like...
First one, innit?
Yeah. And he was like, I think he sounds sick on drill, to be fair.
But he's supposed to be grime artist. So it's like, if he comes through with a tune to... if he comes with drill to Chip, even though his Chip's still waiting, yeah.
Yeah, still waiting.
But
I think it can come with drill to Chip because Chip did rap.
But the thing is, though, like you say, like he sounds sick on drill. But what we found out, if drill artists don't kill me, but grime artists are technically better rappers than drill artists.
Yeah, because
they're better artists. They have more technicality and more versatility with their flow, and they're able to find different pockets than drill artists. You listen to Scorcher on a drill beat.
Nah.
Scorcher is disgusting. Disgusting. It's like listening to Getz on a drill beat.
Mm.
He's going to chew it to pieces.
Yeah, I'll get that.
Because these guys are just, they're better because what they do and what they have done.
Is, you know what? I look at drill. I'm not knocking it, it's just that I find it that grime has more versatility in terms of the actual pockets that you can find.
Yeah.
And because it's like you're more versatile, when you get something like drill, it's like, yeah, I can mash this up easy because I'm used to having to work with this.
Definitely.
I've got to work with this big versatile adapt. You see what I'm saying?
And the thing with drill as well, I feel it's less about how sick you are. And more about what the song, what the vibe is.
Yeah. Drill's definitely more of a vibe.
So you
and
don't,
Stormzy, and, I don't and say it hides the vibe. What is the projection?
It hides the technicality of what you do.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay.
Nah. Definitely.
Okay. I just think that it's kind of like not manufactured, but grime benefits at the end of the day.
It's just that Stormzy hasn't replied.
Does Grime benefit because...
because the thing is now, in a way, yes, because people will go back and look at Chip's catalogue because of this. And
will they?
Some people will, you know, because people will sit there and say, yeah, is this guy talking at my King of Grime?
I think it's a weird one.
That was people who feel that. Your blogs.
Sorry. I think it's a weird one. I thought this when it was the whole Wiley Stormzy thing, and you know how everyone's always like, oh, like you just said, Grime's going to benefit, and Grime is, you know, I think we say this year started well because of Grime. Basically, I don't get what that really means, because Grime is a genre of music, innit? So, like, I don't know how it can be good for Grime.
Because
without everything else being good for Grime,
yes,
You can't only have one thing good for Grime, and nothing else is really keeping the momentum.
It's a case that because drill has been pushed forward that much, it's a case that this may be a avenue for people to try and focus a bit more on Grime. I'm talking about the casual fan.
Yeah, but then I think that only really works when there's new Grime. Like, you can't have Chip and or you can't have all these moments that are good for Grime without someone else then coming through Grime. If it's just, you know, the OG, if it's just the OGs doing Grime, yeah, it's great for Grime as a novelty. But
new artists to come through and start.
But that also comes down to my critique of Stormzy of not doing enough Grime.
And I think that's obviously why Wiley's onto him, because it's like, yo, you've got the power really to at least encourage
empower, like,
just to make the next person do it. You don't need encourage someone else to do it. He's got the power to it's bugging me so much. He's got influence. Must be tired. Yeah. Storms has got the power to influence the next artist to do Grime.
Yeah.
But if he's not going to do Grime himself, but call himself the King of Grime and then do drill, of course, if you're it's Wiley or whatever, like, you're going to be vexed.
The thing with Storms, like, the thing that I don't like is that his music isn't authentically, or like, isn't really like just based in that kind of vein. I mean, as in to say, like, okay, you listen to Home Sweet Home, yeah? Everyone know, classic, Kano, Badman, this, that, and ever, yeah?
Yeah.
But the whole album wasn't just Grime.
Yeah, yeah.
Had, like, bits of flipping, like, ragga or, like, freaking garage or whatever infused. But it's all stems to the same place, whereas Stormzy sounds like he's so melodic in certain parts of his music that it's like it's more R&B / American tainted music.
But you gotta look at it.
I say tainted, tinged, whatever word.
But the thing is, you gotta look at it and think to yourself, see, with Kano's the kind of guy that will always be true to where he comes from.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, it's like I look at Kano and I think I rate him so much just because in this world of kind of like changing your style to suit others, he's one person that's like, no, this is where I'm from and this is what I'm about, and because I can do that and I've stayed like this my whole career, no one can't talk to me.
I don't know if you can say that.
I can,
because
you got to think about it,
it did kind of go a bit poppy at one point.
This is what I'm saying, he tried, it's like the that was early on. That was his second album,
Third.
Was it his third?
What? Method to the Madness?
Method to Madness was very, very... It had Holy Paraga.
Oh, okay. Was it the second one in London Town?
London Town.
Yeah.
There's a song, now, I think.
But that album was, executive produced by Damon Albarn?
Yeah.
You know the guy from Gorillaz?
That's the geezer from Gorillaz, yeah.
Yeah.
My man from...
It's not
pulp.
It is.
What's the song?
The 90s band.
What's it called?
So many people.
Yeah.
That's it's Blur.
Yeah. So basically, yeah.
Bad Boy Nike advert, by the way.
I still say that Kano, yeah.
Nah, we got
himself. Even the Chelsea deal thing when he was a footballer. I mean,
you expect
Chelsea?
What? Turn on.
Yeah, he's a big baller, you know, fam.
I don't see that stuff.
I watched his. He does these, say, interviews, or like, he just sits down and has a Zoom chat with them.
This is the time I was thinking of.
He does
one tune, fam.
It wasn't just one tune.
One tune.
What's it? What album's it off?
Rock and Roller EP. I don't know if it was on the album.
Wonderful.
That tune was obviously that tune was everywhere when I went out.
Really?
Where were you going out to hear that tune?
Oceana,
wasn't it?
I never
went out
and
heard
that.
Eh?
Oceana, we're playing now.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Maybe it was like Atlantis.
You sure it wasn't Flares? Juicy
D,
the three stepping Flares.
True. This is another tune as well. But yeah, okay.
I just think that, like, when it comes to Stormzy, he's kind of like the guy that, okay, cool, this is kind of hot right now. Yeah, so we'll go down this flow. And Stormzy's like, okay, we'll try it. And they'll do it.
I personally feel like where he's now, yeah, where Stormzy's now, and I think this is probably one of the gripes of Wiley, is that, as Jay said, Jay did that so you don't have to go through that.
Mm.
Yeah, so I've done this. I know what it's like.
Stormzy and his poppers be kind of making out, though.
No, I'm not trying to say, like, what I'm trying to say is that if you claim to be the king of grime,
Mike Grime.
Once again, as I said, how many months ago? Mike Grime.
Yeah, but he's not exactly making pop.
But he's not making exactly grime.
Yeah, but I don't want to throw him on the bus and make it. Like, he's not Jay-Z, making the wearing my firm, Rolex. Firm. He's making watered down grime.
Firm. Jay-Z is the king of hip hop, yeah? Jay-Z started making dancehall music tomorrow, all his music, his albums had dancehall cuts on them.
Yeah.
Rihanna would be singing
that. But then don't give him an idea.
But that's like saying by saying that, you kind of ignoring the fact that Jay-Z had a Linkin Park album.
He's rapping, and the rapping what he's done with that mashup. It's a collab album. It's a collab.
Okay, but Jay-Z had Forever Young. Jay-Z had his commercial tunes in the same vein as what Stormzy
makes. Forever Young is with Mr. Hudson, who's with Kanye, who is also part of that team.
So what are you saying about Ed Sheeran's not part of the team? Because Ed Sheeran's part of the team?
What I'm trying to say is...
Ask Wiley if he's part of the team. Wiley will tell you.
What I'm trying to say to you is that... What Jay-Z does... Knowing that Jay-Z is the guy, like, he is hip-hop. That's what his brand is, rap music. Whatever people come in to do, like...
What are you trying to say?
I don't know how to explain it. Like, he's going to give you hip-hop music. He's not going to give you R&B music. He's going to give you hip-hop music that has R&B elements to it.
Jay-Z ain't the most hip-hop guy, you know.
I'm not
like
saying
he's not like, but I'm saying Beanie's, like Seagull.
He's not
Beans. I'm talking about Beanie.
You're right, but what I'm trying to say is what he's giving you, his product, is still
a watered down version of
as rap music.
Yeah, so Stormzy does grime, fam.
But he does rap music. He doesn't do grime.
Stormzy.
Does he have grime music? Grime songs on his album? Yes, he does. But the majority of the album is still rap.
To you more. Bothered about the balance of it.
We've had this discussion before, yeah?
Yeah. I don't disagree. I just want it to be... Yeah. I just want it to be fair. Like a fair fight. I don't think Stormzy is as pop as everyone makes out.
I'm not trying to say pop. Remember I said Stormzy? Urban.
But remember he gets a lot of...
And this is it.
It's a lot of stick.
You know what's mad?
Even H are chilling.
Like, it's mad just because, like, when it comes to... When you hit a level of success... I think it's crazy how your perceptions change. Like, the way people view you is like, he's successful, like, it's pop. But if that music was from a different artist, would it still be deemed as tough just because coming from the successful guys mm. mouthpiece? Now, in terms of this whole beef, whatever, production, now, because regardless of what Chip says, Stormzy's got the Drake effect.
100%.
And because he's got the Drake effect, it's like, in a way, the real people who know about grime and understand it really, they'll be like, you know what? Chip can bar into death,
mm.
but the thing is, Stormzy's still Stormzy. And the thing is that him putting out some mediocre tune, people are like, oh my goodness, yo, Stormzy killed Chip. And the people that really understand this will be like, nah, it was weak. But because he's got that star power and he's got that influence, it's a win.
Mm.
You see what I mean? It's a win.
But this is the thing, I don't think... For this beef now, or whatever's going on, this rap beef, whatever, like, Stormzy can't win.
Why it has to just be, like, yeah. Homer Simpson into the mushies.
Yeah, if he stays quiet, he loses. If he comes back at Chip, it's not going to be as hard as Chip.
I get that.
He can't really win this.
If he says anything, the crowd will be on his side.
Nah, definitely not. This is
casual fan.
There's no casual. This isn't a casual fan beef. Chip doesn't appeal to the casual fan. Chip is a purist. It appeals to the scene.
Grime scene,
you know what I mean? At least Wiley has some kind of crossover to a point where the newspaper would, you know what I mean? Even though they've kind of covered the Chip one, but Wiley had some crossover to a point where it's a little bit bigger than just grime and just the scene. You know what I mean? So, not to say Stormzy has to lower himself to come to Chip, but he's not. Really, that's what I'm saying. No, lyrically you can't, but there's a lot of people who can't lyrically step to, but at the same time he's gonna have to step down to talk to, I'm trying to think of a name, just someone but that couldn't
bar. Even so, like, I don't know, it's he said to him fam, I'm bigger than you, you know, behave yourself. He says something about it's 1.2 and that's a million, not thousands.
Yeah.
Man can't talk to me like Willoughby or Andrew. Come on, nigga, I'm stupid rich. He's saying to him, fam, there's levels to this, you know.
And this is it, though. This is my point, fam. Like, and this is what I just think, yo, you can't lose. He can't lose.
Who can't lose?
Stormzy.
The things are, Stormzy can definitely lose.
He can definitely lose. He can lose to us.
He can definitely lose. And the thing is, this is the thing now, like, he can definitely lose. And the thing with Storms, I think he knows he can't say anything because he knows he will lose.
But the thing is now, my point is that the fact that, you see the video?
Which one?
When he's walking from
Chipyard.
Yeah.
I think, do you know better? I think
that's
just,
what I think.
It just looks weird. Like, and this is the reason why I'm thinking to myself, okay, cool, like, a lot of that, when I saw that, I was like, yo, this just looks weird, like, is this real? Or is it like some, like, we set it off, boom, you drop two tunes, then, whatever.
I don't know, you know. I kind of feel like...
The thing is now, think about this now. This is kind of the first time that Storms is the bad guy. In a way.
Yeah.
Because if Storms is the bad guy...
He's Drake.
This is what I'm saying.
He's Drake.
What do you mean?
Drake turned into the bad boy.
All the bad stuff, but because he's Drake, everyone lets him get away with it.
Drake turned into the bad guy, remember?
Yeah. He was angry when he was writing reviews. He was already. That's what he said. You see that whole video thing?
I was angry, you...
I feel like it's misconstrued.
I think it just looks weird.
No, but it's just free man, free black guys in black clothes in a Lamborghini truck going to Manjaro, isn't it? Like,
but
it's not.
Who does that though? Like,
if we're bred like that. Yeah, so if we just went to someone's yard
and he's not there, middle of the day, and his manager's like, yo, he's not here.
Yeah, but. It could have been for anything. Like if
nah, what?
No, okay,
PS5 controller is yard.
It could have just been for chat. It's like, yo, was that true for real? Like, what? How are you gonna do this? Like, is it? It could have just been a peaceful. It could have been the most peaceful conversation.
If it's a peaceful conversation, follow me.
Maybe Chip wasn't answering his phone.
He has his number because he said he sent in flowers. He said, "I sent you my address."
Yeah, but maybe
that's how we got there.
Okay, one. Maybe
put it in Google Maps.
Sometimes you know you don't have that phone conversation. They've got that respect for each other where Storms is probably thinking, "Yo, we can have this conversation face to face." I don't know.
But things like, even if you like,
it looks weird.
It looks weird. Like really, truly, if he was trying to do something to Chip. It was the middle of the day. It was bright outside.
This is in a Lamborghini. Daylight in a Lamborghini. Yeah. You roll up there in a.
And it was it like
Lambo.
And if you look at the way they were inconspicuous. Yeah. Saying, I don't think it was that though. Sometimes if you look at the way they were even moving back to the car, it was even like yo. It was even like agitating. It was just like, "Yeah, I'm just seeing if you wanted to go Mackie's, isn't it?" Like,
"You want to go Mackie's?"
Yeah, like, "Oh, you don't know if Chip knows the other two guys or not." I think Chip was a bit clever in
how he spun it.
Yeah, in making Storms the bad guy, or just basically giving himself a reason, because I think Chip's just been waiting to drop, but he didn't want to spin it, because Chip's always been the responder. Chip ain't started nothing, so remember, he has that image to maintain. He has to always be the guy that's just sitting there waiting and then get sent for. So obviously, without that video, the narrative is, Chip said this on ways. Stormzy replied, and then Chip did a thingy, so Chip started it.
Yeah.
But obviously now you got this video that kind of makes it seem like, Chip said this some ways, Stormzy said this, but then Stormzy took it to a next level, so now it's, you know what I mean?
Bear in mind, it's clever, I'm buying into this narrative that Chip's given us. So, how he says on Flowers, like, you're sensitive because I said this on ways, you did, I don't know, then this is your next call of response. Like, how does that make sense? How did you get to there?
But what is the next call of response?
Go back at him.
What do you mean?
Go back at him.
What has been Storms' call of response? Going to his house?
Yeah.
But we don't know if Chip knew two guys. Like,
I understand what he's saying.
I understand what he's saying. That could have been Chip's regions. Like,
I understand what he's saying, but the thing is, yeah. With Stormzy.
Stormzy could have been like, "Wow, nah, listen, Adam
listen, 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 listen." The thing with Stormzy, yeah. The way how Stormzy is like, the way how he chiefed up Wiley's brother. Like, apparently saw him in the place, clapped him.
No, but
man can't say nothing to him. But what I think is
that was different though. That was existing thing from issue. Years, I think.
But what I'm trying to say is that I think when it gets to a point, because Stormzy knows lyrically he's not going to do that to him, but he'll be able to physically take it to a place where he wins.
I don't know.
You think
out of the two of them?
Oh, well, yeah, you said he wins in the fight, Stormzy.
Obviously, it's going to be Stormzy. He's like 6'2".
You never know.
You never know, still.
Chip's probably like,
could have that while you, like,
I think Chip's been very clever in controlling. It's learned from Pusha T. You control the narrative, and then you can't lose. If the narrative's straight, you cannot lose.
I hear that.
You can't lose.
Well, I don't know.
Storms is a bad guy.
He's a bad guy.
But he probably shouldn't be the bad guy in this situation.
But he's draking.
I know, but Chip came with the first lines.
But he's draking it.
He's draking it. Storms is Drake in it or draking it?
Draking it.
How? Because Storms ain't done nothing yet. Storms is chilling.
Bottega boys.
Yeah, with Adam and. We don't know. Them two guys could have been anyone. You know, could have been brethren. Could have been the same circle.
Okay.
It could have been the middleman, like, I can't. Obviously, I'm Stormzy. I can't just turn up to you on your own.
Okay.
They could have been his cousins, like, yo.
Yeah, his cousin, yeah.
It could have been.
Mm-hmm.
Say, obviously, I'm trying to. I got beef with you, but I ain't cool with you. But we know Tim. Obviously, you know Tim's your brother. Mm-hmm. All right, Tim, yo, Tim, take agents.
Right,
obviously, cool. Agent ain't there, but your manager's there just shouting, and now it looks like we tried to do something.
Okay.
Don't get me wrong, we can say this, but either way, it's a stupid thing for him to go to the man's yard. Just call him. Like,
nah, it's not, man. It's stupid to go to a man's yard.
Yeah, it's stupid to go to the man's
to
yard.
To talk to someone face to face.
It's stupid when you're that guy.
Yeah, but he probably wasn't expecting Chip snitched on him. Chip 6-9
you
want
a payroll?
I'm making sure it's a fair.
You must be on the payroll, fam.
Because I know we're going to come up here and we're going to just support, obviously, we're all Team Chip.
It's not about being Team Chip. I'm saying to
Stormzy. I know you hate Stormzy.
I'm Team White.
You're moving wrong. Stupid. That's what I'm saying.
I'm stupid.
Stormzy, that was wrong. Not you.
No, I'm trying to make sure
I'm saying
but
Stormzy, you move stupid. That was stupid for you to go to even expose yourself that way. What exposing? You're exposing your hand like that. No, fam. The fact of the matter is, if this was a war thing, yeah, which Chip's trying to make out to be, you've exposed yourself. You made yourself look emotional.
How's that emotional? Stormzy went to Chip's yard. He looks to have like a his head's hot.
It looks like it's
hot. Oh, see, Chips worked on you. Chips worked on you. Fam, watch the video, fam. Then, man, walk back to the car and the calmest thing ever, like, yo.
Fam, his head's hot.
He said, yo, tell him to call me.
There was a bit of steam when he rolled up the hood, like.
Fam. He said, tell him to call me. Obviously, he's getting shouted at by the woman he's thinking,
his head is hot.
And like, if his head was really hot, he would have been shouting back at the woman.
His head's hot. It doesn't need to be going to the man to seem like that unless it's a thing.
Okay. Chip sent him his address. So obviously Chip set this up, you know. Chip set this up.
Nah, fam.
So obviously man sent him.
Moving incorrect.
Man sent him that address, said, yo, meet me at mine at 12. In 12 came, bro. He's not in, manager's there, angry, camera out. Stormzy fell for it?
I don't even know. Let's hope so.
Stormzy fell for it?
I don't know. Anyhow. Yeah, so what was the other topic you're coming with, Tim?
I've got loads.
We've got
loads. How do you guys feel about being told to retrain
and do something else? I heard about that still.
Imagine, just say, do something else.
I heard about that.
How would you feel?
I wouldn't be happy.
Yo, this government's on a mad one. This government's on a mad one.
I mean, it's a bit weird, isn't it?
You know what's funny? Today on BBC, I saw we got the woman who actually took the photo that they're using for the campaign.
Yeah. The ballerina thing.
Yeah. For Fatima, yeah.
That's the name?
That's the name they're giving this girl.
Okay. Oh, yeah, it was. Yeah.
The girl's real name is Desiree.
Yeah.
And she's an American gymnast. And she's a, not gymnast, like ballerina.
Yeah, yeah.
And she's dedicated her whole life to dancing.
Yeah.
And it's insensitive for them to say, oh, retrain, redo,
I've got the very, very.
Reboot and eating.
That's mad still. I think it's just rude. The only person I think needs to retrain, yeah, is that Pure Gym PT who did
the 12 years a slave.
No, 12 days a slave, wasn't it?
Yeah. Boy, for whole 10 stick bucks down, bro.
You see with that, I think, like, there are certain people that you think to yourself, yo, bro, you need to run that by someone. you know, sometimes when you write out, you have an idea on Instagram or Facebook and you write it out and you leave half an hour, then you look back and it's like, no.
Half an hour before I even get to the end of the paragraph.
Delete that.
The last one, just hold it down.
Yeah, delete it all. I mean, because my man, yeah, if there was anything I've ever seen that's been tone deaf, was that. Like, bro. Like. Tone deaf. And the thing is, yeah, I'm thinking, who has a Pure Gym?
Like, password.
No one PT shouldn't be having it.
It's for that branch.
Yeah, I'm like, yo, the manager should have that, not the normal PT.
I mean, come on. You know what's sad? What's really sad? Because I don't think anything it's gonna sound weird, but let me know. I don't think anything malicious was meant by it. I just think literally
niggas halfway up in the air, man's land, man's underneath.
Whoever this PT is, he knows as Black History is slavery. And I think that's the sad thing. It's like, that's the problem. That's Black History Month. What can I do for Black History Month?
That's the problem.
Slavery. Let me get a slavery workout so they feel included. They feel like
that. What
you're
saying is 100% correct.
We're doing Black History Month at work. So in every classroom, we've got Black people that inspire us. Yeah? Mad. Work around words. Black faces everywhere. Like, hey.
Huh? And you got actual Black people or pictures?
Pictures.
Oh, so you sent hair to pictures?
Yeah. Okay. So, obviously, yeah, I chose two people that inspired me. I got 50 and Denzel. And it's mad just because it's shows that the flip side of it. It's like, yo, we're powerful, we're strong, we're intelligent, we are sophisticated. And it's like, for him to have that view, it's sad just to think that, yo, we do loads, you know, fam. Now, the fact that you think that this is what we are and this is just what we are identified as in society, it shows that you're not really educated on who you are as a person. You see what I'm saying? Basically. And that's sad. It's kind of sad.
That's sad. Man, the guy wasn't... Was the guy Black himself?
He was Black. He's Black.
No, I didn't look into the story or anything like that. It was a Black guy that did that.
That's what it said. This is actually very disappointing.
I thought it was just some clueless white guy.
No, that's what it said.
Wow.
Because like you're telling me,
is that guy when you say, "Oh, I'm not racist. I got Black friends."
Yeah, it's him. He's that guy.
Did you show pictures of him or anything?
Yeah, yeah.
Did he look like that guy?
Don't need to speak about that.
Oh, it's Hench.
No, my point is that, yo, at the end of the day, yeah, you got to look at it and think to yourself, we've got so many Black people that have been inspirational, that have been, like, yo, at the end of the day, fam, if you could have done a Black History Month Muhammad Ali workout, boom. You tell me you can't do a Muhammad Ali drills, boom, do that, yeah, and then just pop in. Because that's someone positive, that's someone progressive, that's someone who pushed the barrier for Black people. Bro, and
it's a simple fact.
No way.
He associates Black history with slavery, and because he's uneducated and because he doesn't want to educate himself about his own people.
You can't say that because you don't know him. You might want to. You may be ignorant to it.
Fair dues.
I mean, you can't really make that statement just because, you know, you don't know how to use that.
Fair enough.
It's like, no, I'll tell you that, this may be the actual teachable moment that
it seems like he has been.
You know what, I'm going to actually look at my own history, look at my Black people, where we come from, what we're fighting for, and blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, even though it was a shocking...
Grace, innit? Giving grace.
Yeah, man. It's like, even though it's a shocking situation, you know, you give the man some time, man, just let him learn and pray that he can see, you know, the value in it.
It was a massive misstep, and you know what? I really wish you ran up past someone before he did it.
Fully mad. But the thing is, because he's a Black man himself,
it's changed.
The white manager sat there and said, the white manager could have sat there and said, like, because a Black man saying this, if I say no,
yeah,
like, yes, he can turn to me and say, yo, what are you saying no for?
Or it could have been like, okay, well, if it's okay with you, then it must be okay, innit?
Now,
I can't believe this is a Black guy that did this, you know?
Yeah, and this is the reason why people can't push. It's like I saw people pushing the blame on Pure Gym. I'm like, look, man, you've got to realise, like, look, the fact is, a Black man said this, so they're in a situation to say, okay, cool, if I say no, he can turn around and say, you're stopping me from expressing, you know, my thoughts about Black history, and I'm a Black man. Now, them saying yes, they've obviously got themselves in trouble. Yeah. And it's one of them, man. It's tough. It's really tough. It's not as easy as it seems.
I don't like this article. Basically, saying he's been receiving racist abuse online from Black people.
Black people?
Says, I've been told, keep to your white company, and we're going to take his Black card from him. It's heartbreaking when you look at the sender, and the sender resembles you. But does he not understand what he's posted?
Yeah.
Like, not saying it's right.
It's not excusing it, but...
But, like...
Understand what you've said has caused offence to those people.
Yeah.
But two wrongs don't make a right.
No, no, no. Exactly. Yeah, it's definitely not... It's not right.
You don't know.
But you can't be saying, oh, you want sympathy because people are being racist to you.
No, but it's one thing. It's one thing saying, fam, that was not the one. Compared to saying, yo,
you're not one of us, good.
Your black card has been revoked.
How is the internet, hand man? It's the internet.
Hand it back in, yeah. We will swap. We'll swap you for what's his name?
We had Robin Thicke. We got Justin Timberlake.
Who should we have in the racial draft?
What white person?
Yeah. What about Hero? Tyler Hero, the guy from Miami Heat.
Iron Man.
Have you seen him?
No.
Iron Man ain't black.
Is he?
Oh, he is now, isn't it?
Iron Man.
No, sorry, that's Captain America.
I just think, you know what? It's you can't really like chastise him for that. Just let him learn. Let him learn. Let education be the thing.
You know, but you're saying what's right. This is the internet. Like, of course, he's gonna get chastised.
Yeah.
Like, and he should know that.
True.
He should know a lot of things to be fair.
Yeah, man.
I'm just so shocked this is black,
man. Yeah, man.
It's one of ones like, as a black man, you're thinking, yo, fam, what are going for you, man? You see, saying, yo, fam, what are going for you, though? Like, yo, what, man? What?
Yes, fuck. Is any sound coming from my mic at all?
Yeah. You might have to save it up. Yeah, save it like last time, innit?
I will. But yeah, it's mad. Music. Can we get into music real quick?
Yeah. Well, just quickly because Tim mentioned Coming to America. I haven't seen anything about it. So just.
Coming to America 2.
So I know the film's coming out, but you said something happened.
Yeah, basically, they've sold. I don't know if it's sold the stream rights, but basically they've done a deal where it's going straight to Amazon Prime.
Yeah.
For 125 mil.
Is that good?
I don't know.
Oh yeah, me either.
Give me 125 mil. It's very good.
Yeah, but how much is the film?
How much does that really add up to the streams?
Well, that's probably to do with like. Don't get me wrong, because I don't know the ins and outs of the deal, but this is speculation, and you know speculation. So, they could have a deal where it's, they get this money up front, but they could have some sort of kickback on stream, I don't know.
Mm.
They could also be doing that in comparison to what budget they spent from the studio. I don't know how they've done it.
It's but you know,
it's got 120 something.
It's making money. Can't knock it. That is what it is.
I'm looking forward to it. I just hope that it doesn't ruin. You can't ruin the first
nah,
one.
Nah.
You can't ruin it. Nah, so it's done and dusted by it. So I just hope this is good or as good as the first one.
Mm.
Probably the first one, but hopefully
because. Yeah. I am holding in this gas, you know. Because, you know, again, like, before we started recording, I planned to pop, but then I remembered these microphones.
You planned?
I did plan to.
Did you plan it though?
No, I didn't. I knew I wasn't going to be coming in and out.
You lot see this disgusting human being that I'm working with.
What do you mean? Pop's a natural fam, you know this, science.
Natural. You know what? Take a look at Pop yourself, yeah?
No, don't be laughing, you won't be Pop fam.
That's all I'm saying.
The dog is, I couldn't pop in this whole conveyance.
Exactly.
I couldn't do that to you. Could you go outside and not in the trench room?
Yeah, go outside.
Can you go down the drive?
So Juice is ready to smoke out the studio, you know. As he. This guy.
Studio. Darling. Studio. Come on down.
Make sure you shake it at the bottom as well.
I said.
Pat the back of your trousers, man. You have to do the pat thing, man. Get it out.
What is this guy doing?
Wouldn't it be best if we'd just gone to the toilet anyway?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, so... It's been a long, long
time. So are we going to get you singing?
Yeah, it's coming in now. It's like my mixtape. I've been at the end. I'm a shower singer.
No, no, that's not good.
I'm a shower singer.
We should get you on.
I'm a shower singer.
Get you singing.
Yeah, shower singer. That's what we're going to do, the plates and dishes.
Are you sure, man?
Yeah, man. That's going to get sensual.
Right.
The bubbles in the dishwater.
And is that the dishes of the like Timbo. Right. Oh, there she is again. There she is again. Yeah.
Oh, it's the 17th of October, isn't it?
Is it the 14th of
October? Is it the 16th? Tomorrow? Flipping hell, it's a big fight tomorrow. Lomachenko and Teofimo Lopez. It's going to be a massive fight. For two very small people. No, the guy's small.
What?
No, this guy's really small, you can see.
What, the woman's breast is bigger than that?
Yeah, it's going to be a good fight.
So what?
Weight.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Super bantam.
No. I don't know what weight they are.
You know what I'm thinking? You're still recording, isn't it?
Yeah.
I was thinking, yeah. 120 episodes and I've never popped on mic.
That's good, you know.
Yeah, that's quite good.
Keep it going, fam.
I popped.
Lots of times after.
Oh, yeah, during the mixdown, but that's just a mixdown. It's just me and you.
Oh!
Oh, you know, there's some hefty pops in there. You know what, yo, I've been to say as well. Need your advice, actually.
What?
I did 60 sit-ups on Monday.
Yeah.
And my stomach's still hurting.
Yeah.
It is normal.
Yeah.
Why so long?
Is all that doing there?
Nah, this is something different. This is a different...
Why?
Monday.
When's the last time you did abs? 3, 4, 5.
Before the gym lockdown.
And that's probably why,
isn't it? Yeah, but all week.
Yeah.
That's mad.
Well, what do you think you
can do? In a day, what do you use your abs for?
Just to squeeze out duties.
Are you regular every day?
Okay.
I'm not, yeah. Every morning.
Cool, so.
Morning?
After coffee, innit? After the morning coffee.
Morning?
Yeah.
That's matching my whole routine, man. It has to be like an evening or afternoon thing, man.
So basically.
Sometimes both.
Sometimes
both.
Mm.
So you gotta understand, yeah, that. It's like, if you don't really use your abs that much, you've got to, like, you know, train them. The only thing is, though, is like, when you do train them, they don't help when you go to gym. But when, like, you get cramped, it's not the worst thing in the world.
From the exercising or just getting cramped?
Just getting cramped. So basically, what you'll have is like, you'll have your stomach just goes flat and you have a massive bulging ab. Bulging.
Isn't that a hernia?
No, it's just cramp. Like, yeah, you see how
the muscles just, yeah.
Spasm up and contract. And then that's kind of thing. And the other thing is, as well, if you're sick, that's kind of thing. If you're sick, your body, obviously, what it does. When you're sick, yeah, what it does, it tries to get all the hydrochloric acid and like all the food out of your stomach. So all your midsection, all the abdominal muscles squeeze together, and you can't control that, obviously.
From which end does it come out?
It comes out his mouth, it comes out sick. Okay. Yeah? Because it's thinking to yourself, yeah, you need to clear your stomach, you get everything out, yeah, we'll start from scratch. So then, if you've got really developed abs, yeah, when it squeezes, imagine squeezing your bicep as tight as you can. Then you get cramp in your hand, and you can't open your hand. Imagine that your whole midsection.
See, to basically just stop trading my stomach. Because you're not selling it right now.
So basically, if you're going to train your stomach, be prepared for this.
Because if you are, it's just
like norovirus in them ones.
Literally, if you're sick, if you're sick, I've had this, I was sick, and because my stomach, my head's in the toilet, my head's like above the toilet, and because my stomach's, I'm sick, my stomach's that tight, I've literally played, put your hand on the toilet and stretch yourself
out. Oh, that's great, isn't it? The cobra. The cobra? You've never ever done yoga? Never in your life?
Remember Juice has got the badge on his
The cobra? When you like line your stomach and then hand up.
No, I don't do no cobra.
Do the cobra for him.
I don't need to.
No, we'll do though.
Do the cobra.
No, but it feels like it's everything that you're talking about now, it sounds like you need to do the cobra. You basically done the cobra already. Go on, carry on describing what you're describing. You're describing the cobra.
Well, his stomach is tight and then you squeeze it out and you just have to stretch it.
How you stretch? Cobra duck.
No. No.
That's just your neck.
I'm laughing, you have to go like this. Even though, like 3 seconds ago, I did the same thing. Anyway,
topic.
Did you listen to
a thing? Did you look at my phone? No, I've got it written. No way. You saw my phone, didn't it?
No, I didn't.
You know my passcode?
No.
Oh. Yeah, I listened to it yesterday still. Have you listened to it?
I'm not going to say what I really did.
So just forget this. It's a great joke.
Yeah, I listened to it yesterday.
Trey Songz album.
No, Tory Lanez.
Tory Lanez. Sorry,
Yeah. Obviously, I wasn't really rushing to it because it was kind of nasty. And then listening to it, it just seemed even more nastier. Yeah. But like, it's hard to say. Basically, it seems like there's no... I mean, I understand the whole two sides to a story and that kind of thing, but like, I just didn't like the way it was rolled out. And obviously, why are you releasing albums when there's allegations against you? But
yeah.
fair enough, your side of the story, cool. But, I mean, Tory has to be, like, super innocent for the amount of... Is unaccountability a word?
Yeah.
Joker. Yeah, for the amount of unaccountability that is on this album, Tory has to be like super innocent, like innocent bystander kind of like.
I was in a different car.
Head down, like I don't know.
Whilst praying.
Yeah, because it's like it's mad because it didn't go down like that. So it's like, okay, he's gonna tell us how it went down. Nothing. It's like, okay, like what? What is this album about if it's not going to tell us what actually happened? It's not said that we deserve to know, but like, you're doing an album.
People will find out, so it don't matter.
Yeah, and then it kind of gets a bit nasty because like, there's a lot of like, black empowerment kind of stuff on it. And it's almost as if like, yo, how are you saying I'm not supporting black people? And if you guys are really black, you should be supporting me and that kind of stuff. It's like... I don't know if that's really... I don't know if he understands people's feelings towards him, towards shooting a woman. Not just a black woman, just a woman.
No, but you got to understand,
It's like, oh, how is everyone talking about me? How am I cancelled? Are you not think I'm going to be cancelled? And it's like, yeah, but... People are saying you shot them. Like...
Once again, like, Tory, read the room.
Yeah.
It's like, because it's 2020, anything's allowed, and
unfortunately, if
all these people allow 6ix9ine to get away with what he's done, then, like, everyone's got a free pass to do anything. Now, realistically, I know a lot of people don't care. Do I? I do care. But at the end of the day, the fact is that if Tory's innocent, cool. Yeah. However, if he's not innocent, then he's guilty. All the people that are screaming from the mountaintops are saying, let him out, don't let that rich black spot's going to lose it. I was saying, so, are you saying that because you just want new music? Are you saying that because you actually, like, you know, you actually fully invested in this guy, and if he goes to prison, your heart's going to break and you never want to come out of your house again?
Yeah, it's been charged, isn't it? 22 years.
You get me?
Facing 22 years.
I said to a Bridging, like,
I just think it's insane.
I said this to him on Instagram, and he says, I don't know, man, you have to hear, like, two sides of the story, and you, like, because... I said, fam, but there's nothing else to hear. He said, the woman said that he shot her.
No,
he said, cap, okay, so, if she's talking rubbish, that's not what happened.
But that's what I'm saying, but this is the thing, yes, there is two sides to the story. This album does not say the other side. What there's nothing on this album other than throwing dirt on her name, and you know what I mean? Like,
and at the end of the day, I'll tell you something. It's like, if those two were supposed to be in a romantic relationship.
And this is a bit nasty. Because it sounds like he was like fully in love with her. Like the way he's putting it on this album, it's like a lot of I feel like I could trust you, I feel like, you know what I mean? It's like, what
was that single?
Nah.
If she said that, oh, if you could trust the red hair.
Yeah, you brought my old. Maybe we can still get together, and it's like.
But she said that she tried her best. She told the police. She's in a nutshell. She tried to do something so she knew that he wouldn't get hurt by the police.
Yeah, well, he's saying that it's nothing to do with him. So she sailed him down the river, basically.
So it's got nothing. So he didn't shoot her.
That's basically what it's saying.
So in that case, he's incriminating either her best friend or the security guard. And
there we go.
I mean, it's just saying, no, it didn't go down like that, and how you doing this to me, and
then
there's two sides to the story. And
someone decides to pick up a gun and shoot.
And he's got the, like, how did you get shot in your feet and not hit any major, whatever? Like,
and it's so stupid, because, like, fam, if she's been shot in the foot, and if you cared about... I'm married, fam.
Yeah, if you're shot in the foot,
if my wife's been shot in the foot, yeah.
Come on, please. Can I have one's got a big box?
Last one still. That
ain't your last one. What are you putting the packet back in the box? That's it, living for you. I'll put it with you. Oh, this is your last one?
Yeah.
Oh, no, you keep your last one. I thought that was your last one. No, you eat the last one. I can't eat the man's last one. No, I can't eat your last cookie. Not on camera, fam. When the camera's off, it's cool. Off the camera, innit?
Take it then.
That's your last cookie, man. You've got your emotional connection to the.
I'm being serious to say.
All right, I'm going to eat it later, though, off the camera. Because it's your last cookie. I'm not going to eat that cookie on camera.
Okay, man.
Was I talking? You were talking?
No, I wasn't.
Yeah. What, man, don't get that invite,
though, innit? No invites went out.
Yeah.
Man, give man his cookie again, me, man. Man, don't get no invite, though.
Juice is the real six gun.
You get me? My son has a birthday million, though. Adrian Cross.
From the six people that can come. And the joke is,
I was not number three.
It's a joint birthday.
I was number 10.
It's a joint. It's me now.
It's alright.
So obviously, there's only four spaces now, isn't it?
It's alright. I said it's alright.
So technically, you should be able to, like, do three, six people each.
Is Nile give you his last cookie?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yes?
He ain't giving you today.
I answered now for a couple.
Coincidentally.
And he's your friend.
And he's your friend.
No, I had my shoes in his bag going up Snowden still.
What's that got to do with anything besides Snowden?
I know, but it's pretty...
It's cookies. What's that got to do with anything?
Cookies, nigga.
Yeah, but you said the cookies are worth more than Snowden?
Yeah.
And you would say that, of course.
You would.
All right, new music.
I'm having a birthday meal still.
I wasn't invited to your last birthday meal,
you're not invited.
No, I got uninvited for your birthday. I was like, oh, yo, you replied a bit too late, you know, yo. Table's already been booked, you know. I was like, oh, all right, of course, eh? That's in the menu price. I was like, oh, I don't even mind.
In a word.
So I was going to buy a t-shirt. Anyway. I was going to buy a t-shirt. It's safe. All right, new music. Anyone?
I heard it's supposed to be a good album. I haven't listened to it.
I heard it's a good album. I don't see it.
I don't see it.
I don't. I've been looking forward to listening to the album, and then I got, like, I think it's five tracks in. I was thinking, ain't this supposed to be like a really good album? It's not a bad art. It's just more of the same, pretty much.
Okay, so what are we being listening to? I had to go flush that block,
climb on the court of rain. I really had to be feeling apart, she said. Yeah, it's not bad. I don't know, it's just more of the same. I really thought maybe it'd be different. Let me get to the end of the album before I really give it a proper. No, I knew I forgot something, nah. But that's not new anyway, isn't it? Like throwaways.
It's some throwaways. But I like some of this
stuff. Party pack.
You'll like it, I think.
Yeah, I like party. Right, and like I like to party.
Hey,
man.
Party time.
Mm.
I'm just part
there. Oh, yeah. Is it that good? Because it's really been hyped up.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been hyped up a lot.
Mm.
It's important to play you need, isn't
it? Yeah, I hear that.
You need
me
for
years. Yeah. Better than
Kante. Obviously, probably.
It's not obvious. Remus. Nah, Kante's black still. Kante's. I don't think you can get blacker.
No, Kante's got hair.
Mm. You know, I don't think.
So bad. So bad.
Yeah, I don't know, to be fair. Savage Mode 2, that's what I've been listening to, man. Let's be fair. I think I said it to you last episode. It's sick, but you won't like it.
I won't.
You won't like it.
I like Tuna Savage.
You like Tuna Savage? Yeah. You? Yeah. You don't like Tuna Savage. It's nowhere near as technical as you like your rap.
No, I actually like Tuna Savage. That's not even like a joke. I generally like Tuna Savage. And he's a very technical rapper. Some of the things he says, hilarious. Genius.
I do like 21 Savage, but I don't think you can listen to the whole album.
Okay.
Nah, it's sick, man.
Okay.
It's sick.
Look, his last album's really, really good.
Which one was the last one?
The Black and White one, I thought it was called.
I wasn't that keen, to be fair.
I thought it was really, really good.
You know what? I mean, as much as I do like 21 Savage, Metro Boomin, man. Like, I've always been a massive fan.
Yeah.
And, yeah, I think it's really his every song.
Are we happy about 21 Savage being UK?
21.
Well, doesn't really change anything.
Okay. Don't really change anything, to be fair.
I think
he's born in the UK, but he lives in America.
Wasn't he born in Bermuda or something like that?
I don't know.
No, I'm sure he's like born in. Is it like Bermuda technically? Born in London. Oh, that's the born in London.
Yeah.
You Google that quick.
That's why you called UK.
No, because if you I think
dual
if you
heritage or something.
If you're born in, is it Bermuda? Where it's technically British Ireland or whatever.
But if you're born in Jamaica when it was ruled by Jamaica, you don't class yourself as born in the UK.
Yeah, you got a point there.
I don't know. Did you know more about when Jamaica was...
Yeah, it's only the other day it was made independent.
Mm. Yeah, that's mainly what I've been listening to. I listened to the start of Benny.
I listened to Benny all the way through. I ain't gonna lie to you, it's not a Griselda project. It don't sound like that until the one song.
Is
that a good thing or not a bad thing?
I think it's a good thing.
Well, Benny, it's never really sounded Griselda-ish anyway. It's always reminded me of that
rap.
The Cassidy era, like Papoose.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like the way he structures it, the punches at the end of the bar, every bar.
Yeah.
If not every other bar, like. Yeah, Benny's. I just hope the man are appreciated, man. Like, you know, especially doing the pod, like, you always hear like, "Oh, rap's dead, man," and you're never gonna get that old school. But like this is that. This is that.
The thing I think that because music's where it is now, the real people, obviously, there's people that do know about Griselda, Westside, you know, Benny, whatever. But it's just the mainstream.
Well, that's what I'm saying. There's the mainstream now, but I think because the mainstream was so or is so prevalent, even like Kendrick Cole, there's mandem that don't connect with that at all. You know what I mean? So if when it comes to rap for you, let's say you're mandem, you're street guy, whatever, and your option was Future, Uzi, whatever, and or Kendrick Cole and them, like, or Drake. It's like, fam, loud rap. You know what I mean?
Mm.
I'm listening to drill now. Mm. You know what I mean? So when you can see there's actual rap out there again now, I want them to gravitate towards that.
But the thing is, yeah.
It's almost as if they've probably given up with that's rap
the
now.
Thing, I think a lot of the guys that always stick to their, yo,
old school DMX or old school.
Yo, there's man out there
that's doing it, you get me? So just I personally feel it's just that they're lazy.
So yeah, like, lazy. You don't want to change, you don't want to open their mind to a new rapper, you don't want to open their mind to a new
voice. Like, it is lazy, but at the same time a lot of people don't actually search for music. Just casual listeners. Not if that's not what you're about. How is it?
Okay, then cool. So, if someone says some brand new 110s out, and you just buy Air Max 95 all the time, man says, yo, this brand new fire out, you know.
But you're not the guy that searches for fire?
And then you're moaning about, oh, I've only got these one type of crap. You just need to look. That's laziness. You not looking is being...
Okay, yeah. Now, if you're going to moan, I'm saying the past the moaning, they've just given up. Like, they're not even moaning about music now. It's just like, you know,
this man just moaning. Yeah. Yo, no good news, bro. Mm. They're actually easy.
Yeah. I mean, it has been for a while, but it's almost as if it's like sub underground. I know it doesn't make sense, but it's like you got underground, then you got underground. Yeah.
Jamiroquai.
Literally. Godzilla Star.
I don't know.
There's too much panic in this town.
Gone deeper.
Underground.
Bringing sexy back.
I was just
trying to keep up, innit?
That's just Justin Timberlake.
Yeah, but it's a J, innit? It's close, man. It's close enough.
It's going, man.
But Benny,
hopefully, you know,
school man can pick up Benny. But aside from that, I've been listening.
Yeah, it's a good album though.
I listened to Party.
I spoke rap person. I never listened. I heard it was 20. Eh?
Last week, Drew.
Oh yeah, I heard it was 22 songs. I said nah, like that stuff.
That's the thing. It goes well. Your mentality towards album has changed.
Nah, but I've never been an R&B. It's R&B, isn't it?
I looked at the Benny album today.
It's trap.
I'm joking.
If it's trap, I'll listen to 22 songs.
I'm joking.
I looked at the Benny album today. I thought, okay, Benny dropped. Okay, cool. How many songs is on there? I saw 12. I was like, oh, okay.
38 minutes though. I've seen that.
I was like, 12. I can deal with it.
Nah, a long rap album. If it's R&B, I don't listen to R&B like that.
R&B.
Yeah, well, you're R&B guy.
No. But yeah,
Try
Songs, album decent to be fair. It's got a few tracks that are not, obviously you got your Try Songs film, but you've got like, you know.
There's one song on there, I genuinely thought that it was, the way the song's structured, I thought it was done by Daniel from Division.
Okay.
It's the one with about Kitty got the
cat. Oh, I know you're about. Yeah, I know.
The way how the song sung, how it's structured, like I thought it was a song by Daniel, but yeah.
Mm.
It isn't.
Yeah. I don't like the way you called him Daniel.
What's his name?
Just called him Division, innit?
No, because it's the two of them.
I know, but that's what people usually do. I know, that's something I don't like, that you're trying to distinguish yourself from people.
I'm laughing because earlier Tim was constantly calling Stormzy Storm.
Yeah.
I found that hilarious. That's why I laughed.
Yeah.
But I was trying not to laugh because I was like, now the deep in conversation.
Yeah.
I was like, fam, you're not friends.
To be fair, I thought he was going to call him Michael.
Oh, Big Mike. Like, yeah. Mike's, you know what I mean? Mike's.
Yeah, Michael went to his Storms. House.
Okay, I'll call him Stormzy next time. Okay. Sounds
lovely, definitely. Aside from that, have you listened to anything else? I listened to, I listened to the Brandy and Ty Dolla $ign song.
I heard that earlier.
That was alright. Nah, nothing crazy.
Brandy and Ty Dolla $ign, what you mean?
It's just what's called, it's the same, it's
R&B, yeah, just R&B, man. I just don't.
You see the song that's on the album that's just been remixed?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I listened to that, I listened to, what else? Right there. I listened also to... I listened to quite a few tunes.
I finally listened to that Janae Deluxe.
I listened to...
Do you feel complete?
Well, have you heard this tune?
Song.
Yo.
Yo.
This tune came on shuffle, yo, you know.
Blood. I'll tell you. That,
I had to pull over the car.
Yo. Yo. The fairy. Jesus.
I listen to...
That's when I pulled over, so I was like, oh, what's she saying? So let me just pay attention to this. I'd search this kind of video.
The album. Video. It's a really nice album.
Yeah. It's so nice cover too. Yeah. I mean, okay, I was in the parking bay. I was already parked. This sounds better when you say, you know, ooh, hold on.
Juice is driving 40 miles an hour.
Whoa. God damn.
Is that good to accept?
What else you listen to?
I listen to one Stevie Wonder tune with Rhapsody, Cordae, and Buster.
Oh! What did I hear the other day? Terrence Martin.
Terrence Martin, what has he done?
Album
or... James Blake got something out new as well.
I don't know, you know.
I'm sure he has.
There was a Rock Nation album that came out last
week. Yeah, that came out last week.
Oh, and J Electronica?
Yeah.
That's only on Tidal, so you'd have to tell me about that one.
I haven't listened to it.
Mario came out, I haven't listened to that yet. T.I.'s came out, I didn't listen to that yet.
I want to listen to T.I. because the Trinity Gogo was a good song. It's a good song.
From what song did I hear? Terrence Martin, man. You don't know about Terrence Martin?
Yeah, no, Terrence Martin. Oh. I don't know what song it is, though.
I heard it and I thought, Tim definitely listens to this.
Gucci,
Terrence Martin, Robert Glasper, Cordae,
Black Thought as well. So you know, I'll give that a listen.
To. A Ninth Wonder.
Yeah, sounds like a ninth.
Yeah, the cover and everything. I was like, yo, Tim's definitely. Got
oh
this.
Yeah, I saw the album cover, but I haven't listened to it.
Dinner Party. Yeah, seven tracks. But yeah, that's really nice.
But yeah, man.
You like Cardi's nipples?
Yeah.
No, I didn't.
You didn't see them?
No.
Yeah.
Is that one where I just put it on Twitter and it comes up?
Yeah
it should do. do you like big areolas?
I didn't ask about that.
I'm asking you. Do you like big areolas?
So what was the search that you put in?
Big areolas. Cardi's big areolas. Okay. Someone said Ariola Grande.
Stop it. On that note, I just still said shit. Messy
time. You know what the joke is?
Oh, God.
And yeah, people are horrible, you know. Yeah, people are horrible. People are horrible. Like, oh, I don't know.
Whoa.
Like, a big areola is like normal, really, isn't it?
You know, Isa, I think it's just people that are weird on the internet that are like, oh, look at that.
Man, yeah.
So you read what it says there?
That's the only thing I read. Yeah, it's not what it is.
You've got no manners.
I think someone tweeted, it was like, oh, if that's what happens to your areolas after childbirth, I'm definitely not getting pregnant. I was like, you stupid idiot. Ridiculous. People are just...
Sure.
Stupidness.
It's just dumb, but, you know...
The internet, ain't it?
The internet, man. Internet's got nonsense. The internet's just dumb. And it's like mainly young kids that just got nothing to do and they don't go outside because they're shook with everyone.
And Corona. Sure, Corona.
But yeah, aside from that,
Giveon has got a project out.
Nice EP, man.
Yeah, I just need to listen to it.
Tune with Snow on there. Nice.
Yeah.
Like Snow's been doing it. Yeah, she's been doing a lot of features.
Is there video? Is there a video on it?
I don't think there's a video. She's doing a lot of features though. She's got another one out today as well.
Snow got you out today.
Feature.
Oh, feature.
Feature. I listen to it still.
Who is it with?
I don't know the
guy.
This girl.
Is it a girl?
Yeah.
Oh.
Her name is Reggie Snow.
Here we go.
Okay.
Paul
Mirrors. And St. John's got a tune called Gorgeous.
Yeah, I heard that.
Is it?
Yeah, some big tunes still.
Mm.
I've listened to that Frozen 2 soundtrack as well.
Into the Unknown's alright, innit? It's a good song. I think it bangs.
I don't. I've got to when I'm older. To be fair.
Okay, yeah.
This will all make sense when I am older.
A year old.
It is.
What have
you
been playing it now?
I've got kids.
Yeah, I've got kids.
You don't listen to it?
No, we've gone past it now. We've gone past that Rolando, that album.
Okay.
You know what I mean? But yeah. Anything else?
Travis Scott friend. Oh, YG dropped an album as well.
I haven't listened
to that yet.
I've
still
listened to YG, to be
honest. Yeah, I used to be a fan, but I saw it and I'm just like, okay. I did listen to it in the end, but it wasn't... I can't remember it. Yeah, I'm done, man. I'm done.
That is that.
Let's go listen to some 21 Savage. Like, do you really think he's like, he's like a super gangster? You know, like, you know what I mean when I say like super gangster?
Who? Do you know
who
it is?
Who's
that? Bentai? Bentai. Oh. Lines. I don't know who Bentai.
Could have
been given the NBA.
Mm.
Wolves.
Judo.
Mad.
Okay.
Just fucking care for that thing.
Yeah, man, big up.
Congratulations, Bentai and White.
Big up, man.
Ping the ting. This is Hard Food Podcast.
This
is...
You'll see these two doing the floss.
By black culture.
You just did it.
It's still not hip.
Not hip? No. It's a bit hard on yourself. Nah. I'm ready to wrap up and eat this cooking.
Into the unknown.
No, I didn't get it. But anyway, looking in, he's like, I want to respond, but I know if I do, he's got me. But yeah, man, like, share, subscribe, all them thing there, and we'll see you next time. Obviously, y'all know when it takes us for the video.
Two years.
So, just wait.
Last week, he got to Monday, and I said, oh crap, I ain't done the video. and then the next time I thought about it was Thursday.
I tell you guys, I was like, oh crap, I ain't done the video.
I'm going to get it out.
You know what it is? In the group chat, yeah, I've stopped even commenting about, like, when he's not talking about the video coming out, yeah.
I'm gonna sort it out, man.
I just look at it and laugh. I look at it and laugh because I think Tim is not going to do this.
That was me, though. The joke is, Tim popped up. He's like, "Yo, we're putting this week." I was like, "The video, video's out."
I'm like,
"Tim
is not going to do this."
What I'm trying to do, yeah, because we're doing it every 2 weeks. I don't know what to try and do the video so it still hits every week. If that makes sense.
Yeah.
The sooner the better.
How?
Because if you, so if we're 1 week behind on video, we'll still be able to do every week drop.
No.
Thanks, Uncle. Awesome.
Would that not make sense?
Are you not going to catch up somewhere? And then...
No, that doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make sense?
Mm-mm.
So, every week... You know what? We can talk about this off camera.
Let's go. Last time, you as his good friend gave him some cookies. Yeah, we don't want to
eat his birthday meal. What was that?
Look at him. Terrible guy. That sound not awesome.
All right, ta-ra. Lovely.
Yeah, man, big up yourself.
8 years in your eyes.
Enough love, enough respect. All the love.
I said, I'm going to tell Niall. I'm about to go, ooh.